Hey guys, welcome to another episode on My Perspective. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Excel to build and track your own portfolio. Of course, a lot of brokerage app on your phone may do a lot of this for you, but not all of it, right? So this is where Excel can provide that additional value. In my previous video, I showed you how you can create a stock watch list using Excel. And in this video, we'll just be building on that concept. The link is posted in the description below if you haven't seen it already. Again, make sure you have Office 365 with the latest version of Excel, or you'll need to do this on Excel online. Using Excel, we're able to perform calculations and generate a lot of graphs that can really provide insight to your portfolio and the market in general. Say, for example, you want to know the extent of diversification in your portfolio. And using Excel, we can show you not only diversification across stocks, but the different levels of composition within the industries that you're invested in. Well, in all honesty, this depends on what kind of investor you want to be, right? Do you want to be more of a hands-on person, or do you want to just let it do its own thing? And I'm sure you guys are familiar with this. With all else being equal, the theory is that the more effort you put in, the greater the rewards. I mean, at the end of the day, you want to know where you're putting your hard-earned money, right? Well, I hope that's a yes for you. So first, we'll look at how you can set up your portfolio in Excel, and then we'll see how we can play around with the data to address the issue of diversification. And last but not least, performance doesn't really mean anything unless there's a comparison. So I'll show you how you can benchmark your performance against the general market. First off, for this portfolio, I'll use a hypothetical one. Off the top of my head, I'll write the first 10 stocks I think of. So don't read too much into my choices. These are purely hypothetical. So we'll turn these tickers into the stock data type. The readily available attributes I would put are the ticker symbol, which will come in handy later on, the current price, industry, market cap, and the PE ratio. Obviously, these attributes are not enough, so we'll need to add in our own attributes such as quantity, market value, cost, and total gains and losses. The total gains and losses will be the overall percentage gain or loss relative to your cost. In order to produce these columns, we'll need to build a separate sheet called transaction history. So the sheet will have the buys and sells you've made so far. And the idea is to feed this information through so the portfolio table is updated automatically. This transaction history table would include the date, ticker symbol, the action, whether it's buy or sell, quantity, price, and the total amount. So again, hypothetical transactions. Now let's go back to the portfolio table. For quantity, we can now feed this from the other sheet. We don't really want to manually add the quantity because that would make the table pointless. For this, we can use the SUMIF formula. Basically, this formula means if a certain criteria is met, then we want the sum of it. This formula takes three inputs. The range is the cells in the transaction history table that have the ticker symbol, as this is the reference Excel uses to add up the transactions. In this case, the criteria we're using is the ticker symbol, because we want to add up all of the quantities of the transactions that relate to that ticker symbol. And the last input is fairly easy to understand. The sum range is the cells in the table that you wish to add up, which is the quantity column. This table is really useful when you make a lot of transactions and you're wanting to calculate the average cost of your position. So using the SUMIF formula again, we can calculate the total cost of your position. Then you can simply take the total cost and divide that by the quantity. So once we have those columns, market value and total gains and losses are just a matter of using formulas. So market value would equal the current price times the quantity, and the total gains and losses would be dividing the difference between the market value and the total cost by the total cost. Before we can start analyzing diversification, we need to add another column which calculates the percentage of each stock in the portfolio. This is simply the value of the stock divided by the total value of the portfolio. Okay, so we've got a fair bit of data now. Let's go ahead and make some charts. So we'll go and select the relevant columns. In this case, we'll select the column with the ticker symbols and also the percentage of portfolio column. So if you don't know what type of chart you should use, you can head over to the Insert tab in the ribbon and click on Recommended Charts, where Excel will give you some suggestions based on your data. Go through the list and see what type of chart you like. The aim is to pick a chart that tells the story, right? In this case, you can see that the pie chart is probably the best, but you never know. Some people might like bar charts, but personally, I'd go for the pie chart. The default style of the chart is a bit hard to read, so we'll change the design up a bit. We want each of the sections of the pie to be clearly labeled, so we'll go to Add Chart Element under the Chart Design tab and click on Data Labels to select Data Callout. Now the chart is looking much better. If you want to chart by industry, you'll have to create some sort of summary table, as you'll realize that Excel won't group the same categories together if we use the same method as before. The simplest way to create a summary table is to use pivot tables. First, we'll select the table and navigate to the Insert tab in the ribbon and click on Pivot Table on the very left. So now you can start constructing the summary table. So we're basically recreating the table, but with a more powerful sorting function. For example, let's grab the industry field and percentage of portfolio field. So let's create this pie chart. You realize that if you switch the industry field with the stock field, Excel will produce the same chart as before. And another function that could be useful to you is adding slices. There are two kinds of slices, a general one and a timeline one. Adding slices give you the flexibility to carve out the data you want. Using an industry slicer, you're able to delve further into the specific compositions within each industry. But what does this all mean, you may be wondering. I'm sure we all know the saying that we shouldn't put all our eggs in one basket. On the face of it, it may seem very straightforward, but it all depends on how you look at it, right? What type of basket are you holding? What is it made of? Are there cushions in your basket? I know all this may sound abstract. What I'm really trying to say is, how well do you know your investments? Simple questions you can ask yourself. Do I know what the company does? How many revenue streams does the company have? Is the company itself diversified enough? Now that brings me to my next point. Do you want to perform better than the market? I'll show you a way you can benchmark your performance against the overall market using Excel. So our aim is to compare our performance with the markets. Let's just compare our year-to-date performance with the S&P 500. But first, you'll need to export the year-to-date balances for your portfolio. Next, we'll need to download the year-to-date data for the S&P 500 and navigate to historical data and make sure the date is YTD. Apply the filter and click download. We'll be using the adjusted close price, so you can just copy this column over to the same sheet with your balances. Since the two sets of data are on different scales, we need to standardize or rescale one set of data to the other. Here, we make the first cell the same, then after that, it's just a simple exercise of multiplying the previous day's balance by the percentage change. Now, we can plot them on a line chart to see how they fare with each other. Bear in mind that the appreciation in your account balance may include dividend reinvestments or any deposits, withdrawals that were made during the year. If that were the case, then you may need to adjust for those events to get a more accurate picture of your portfolio's performance. In short, this is quite a good way to see whether you need to make adjustments to your portfolio composition
Of course, it will depend on how much risk you can take. For example, can you tolerate your portfolio to decrease more than the market during bad times, but be compensated for by a larger increase when there's good times ahead?
Wow, that was an intense session on Excel. I hope I haven't worked your brain too hard. Though I definitely encourage you guys to build something similar, as it can really increase your knowledge and exposure to the equity markets. Although it doesn't have the full set of data, but it can still do some pretty simple but powerful analysis. Again, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Feel free to post any suggestions or questions that you may have down below, and I'll see you next time in my next video.